You know, I always get jealous of the Eastern Cape because they just somehow seem to produce everything. If it's not Rugby World Cup winners, it's, you know, great actors. If it's not that, it's, you know, iconic political activists and even singers. And the gentleman that joins me in studio today is one such. His name is Lloyiso. He's been famous since he was a teenager. And yeah, he joins us today on My First Hit. Good morning.
Good morning. Wait, is it morning or is it like, okay. Well, it's not morning. It's not afternoon yet.
Yeah, well, I'm not surprised why you're confused because you're late. So, I mean, like,
you know what? Can I tell you the honest truth?
Please, please.
I panic when it's like load shedding and it's traffic.
Right.
I panic because I can't drive during traffic because I come from PE. There's no traffic in PE. There's no traffic in PE. And you come to Joburg and then you're just like in that main street, bro. Witkoppen Road.
Yeah.
Terrible.
I know.
Terrible.
When I was still on the national station and every time we got traffic reports on the show, I was like, okay, what about Gobercha? Like, is there no traffic there?
There's no traffic.
But I mean, are you always late or is it just like that rare occasion? Like, what's your relationship with
time? Are you attacking me right now?
I am, actually. Because at this stage, the only thing that's on time is your career. Like, everything.
Even that, I feel like even that is late.
Never.
But you know, no, I'm not always late. I feel like I'm I always come at the right time.
All right.
This is the right time.
Well, it sounds like it is, especially when we think about your career. Now, a lot of people might talk about idols.
Yeah.
But can we take it a step back and talk about SA's Got Talent?
Oh, yeah.
Because you tried out on there.
Yeah.
And you were what, 14?
I was 14 years old. It was Ian, Kubanga Nene, the lady in the middle, the Unati of SA's Got Talent. What was her name again?
Was it Lala Hirayama?
No, Lala wasn't there that time.
Or even before that?
Yes.
Okay. While we try and download our memories.
And then it was DJ Fresh.
Yes,
DJ Fresh. DJ Fresh saw me there for the first time. I don't think he remembers this.
Yeah.
Because we bumped to each other all the time. We bumped on each other all the time. And I'm like, yo, I did SA's Got Talent. Don't you remember me when you gave me a no? I'm joking. He gave me a yes.
And then he's like, oh, my man. No, I don't remember you, my man.
And he's so humble, eh?
Yeah.
So, yeah, I did SA's Got Talent when I was 14. I got yeses and then they just didn't pick me. Oh, they said I run around like a lost goat on stage. Apparently, I was moving around a lot.
What do you expect from a teenager? I mean, you're 14, bro.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? There's no composure when you're that age.
Yeah.
Which raises questions about like what on earth you were thinking about and doing before you even started to enter competitions. Mm. It sounds like you obviously knew you were talented. Who told you you were talented and what was happening in your life before you even tried out on SA's Got Talent?
It's the girls, man. The girls are always a motivation.
Really?
You know, yeah, the girls, once you start singing, they go, they scream. You're like, oh, I'm that guy now.
And this is at school, obviously. Like,
no, this is actually a church. I started a church.
Yeah?
I'm joking. It's not the girls. It's the Lord, actually.
It's the girls. Sent by the
it's
Lord.
It's the Lord. So yeah, I started a church. Yeah. My family is very musical. We love singing. We sing together. I mean, any black family is a musical family because I always experience music when I attend any black people's functions or like go to anything, any prayer meetings, any umsebenzi. So music has always been a big part of my life.
Yeah.
And my sister had the most amazing catalog of music inspirations that she always used to listen to. She used to listen to a lot of Beyonce.
Oh.
A lot of, I watched a lot of like Camp Rock, Dreamgirls.
I see. So, and there's a lot of music there.
Yes, there's a lot of music. And I gravitated towards music more, and my sister does other things. She's business minded. She's an entrepreneur, but she also sings very well.
So you took all the creative energies in the family.
I took it.
So in other words, you've always wanted to be on the spotlight, or was it the singing and people's reactions when you were young that said, hey, hang on, I'm enjoying all the spotlight. You know, maybe I should just continue.
I don't know. You see, now the difference is, now I'm more like, I don't know if I care about the spotlight more than I care about just actually singing.
Okay.
Like, I don't think I care much about being famous, but I know that fame brings a lot of other things, opportunities, global recognition,
and more girls, but we'll chat about that in just a moment.
Are you pushing this girl's agenda?
I want to go to the music quickly because my producer and I'm well convinced that Seasons was the song that kind of like dropped you in.
Of course.
Right?
That was the biggest one. So that's the biggest
let's
one.
Let's go there now, and then we'll chat more about like what happened from that point and even slightly before, because you're one of the few artists who were famous before they were famous and then got famous. Like, it's...
Wait, what?
Yeah, I'll make it sense or make sense of it in just a moment.
Okay.
Yeah, Seasons. So where it all started. That's Lloyiso on 947. This is Seasons.
Call me. I used to say that when I was breaking up with girls. Don't call me. Don't call me.
Yo.
And you better and not.
I hope they got the message. You know what I mean?
Nah. I didn't do that.
Look, I mean, the bottom line is that there is some sort of memory and emotion that comes to mind and to heart when this song plays. What is that for you when this song came out?
I think this was such a big big moment for me because I was trying out something new, and at that time a lot of labels were trying to sign me. I was blowing up on TikTok. I was going crazy on TikTok. I was hitting numbers, millions, like every second post I did.
Talent search competitions is kind of where it all started. SA's Got Talent said no, including people like DJ Fresh. And then at some stage there was Idols.
DJ Fresh.
Now, season 11 of Idols was interesting because that's kind of like the platform that gave you rise.
Yeah.
And as I said earlier, you actually famous before you were famous. In other words, before Seasons even came out, right? Yeah. Same season as Amanda Black. You didn't win that competition.
Yeah.
Neither did she.
Nope.
Where did you finish again?
She wasn't even selected to be in the top 16. In fact, Amanda Black.
And you were
I was.
You were like sixth or
I was fifth.
Fifth. Yeah.
I was fifth.
And had you paid attention to it? Were you like, Amanda's gonna go somewhere in life, or were you like, I can sing better than all of you?
I was yes, actually I was, I can sing better than, it's a competition. I'm not here to see your potential. No, bro, I'm here to get somewhere.
Yeah.
And I was a kid, man. I was so excited, and I was really willing to learn. And Amanda Black was a big sister to me in the competition. She really, really like held me down when I was, you know, spiraling and kind of was in a bad space at certain times when it's elimination night,
sure.
When it's Sunday night, you know, she calms me down when there's any commotion or somehow, because I don't know how to deal with those kind of things, those emotions, because I'm still young, you know. So she kind of helped me a lot in terms of dealing with these things and dealing with people saying bad things, you know.
And now how do you deal with that? With everything that you've learned, what you've seen, how you became popular through social media and talent search competitions with Idols, etc. How then do you deal with the good, the bad and the ugly about the industry?
I mean, I still get anxious. I sometimes just try to get away from social media as much as I can, because there's so many bad things happening, so many bad things people are saying about people. And I think my escape is music. I always just listen to music. I always just put on my AirPods or just start playing the piano at home. It doesn't really affect me, you know. I have things that I just do on myself, on my own, and I have friends and family. So
have you kept the same group of friends that you had before you were famous?
Depends. Before I was famous, when is before I was famous?
Okay, so, like when you were, like when you were 12. It started really early with you.
I mean, out of high school, I don't think I have the same friends or I chill with the same people, because we all moved away and everybody's in a different space, everybody's in a different city. So we kind of, yes, we communicate. I'm still in touch with some of my friends from high school.
Sure.
But I've got an amazing group of friends that, you know, I've met along the years. And as a mature adult, or like as a 24, 23 year old, you know, I'm growing and I'm learning things about myself. I'm finding new things that I'm interested about. So I'm no longer 16 or 18 years
old. You're wiser now.
Yeah, I'm
leaner and meaner.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So I meet people that I'm like, oh my God, oh wow, we actually have a lot in common.
Sure.
So I've definitely had a lot of friends that have come and gone.
So then how have you then decided to navigate your career at this point, knowing what you know about how evil it can be with labels like Ambitious, where you pointed out that they still owe you money and they ripped you off? How have you then decided to set up your career?
It's you know what, man? You know what I've really been thinking about is that it's bigger than me. Like, whatever could happen right now, whatever, however someone's going to rip you off, they're going to rip you off no matter what you do.
Yeah.
And I think, yes, I've taken better precautions. I've had lawyers, you know, I've had a manager, proper manager this time. And it's been absolutely amazing in putting everything together for me. And I've got an amazing team. It's just the trust thing. I trust the people that I'm around. They know what I've been through. I've spoken to them many times. I've been traumatized. I'm like, you know what? I don't trust people because of this.
Yeah.
And you know, there's been progress in me trusting the team that I'm with right now. So,
speaking of progress, what are your ambitions? Excuse the pun, but like, okay, let me take this that guy. Back. Where do you want to go, particularly in where you want to take your career and your music? Also thinking about the global platform. We're seeing so many artists from South Africa just doing amazing things. Mm. And you've had a taste of that in recent times as well.
I mean, my journey is so fascinating because the sound that I've done and the kind of music that I've done, it's always different. There's really never something that stays the same. But the fact that I'm singing from a point of emotion and I'm putting myself bare in the music, I think that's one thing that's consistent in my music. But the sound keeps on changing. Sure. So I think me evolving helps me stay excited and stay hungry to go further. And I don't know when I'm going to hit the billboard moment, but I'm not in a rush. I'm not looking for a hit right now. I'm just making music.
Speaking of hits, let's play I Hate That I Care.
I Hate That I Care.
Tell me about the song before I play it.
So I was in LA a month back and I was working with Paul Famous. Paul Famous is, he wrote Lost by Frank Ocean.
Damn!
He's an incredible writer.
Wow.
And I was sitting with him with Ethan. Ethan is a producer and we were sitting and we had just done a song and he was like, bro, you know what, man? I think he's so talented, man. I'll even fight you for you, man. I'll fight you for what's best for you, man.
Yeah.
And I'm like, Paul, thank you so much. And then I started playing it on the keyboard and then I just came up with the song, I Hate That I Care. When we go back and forth every time, and I fall for each and every lie, but watching you fall apart, ooh, rips a hole in my heart. Ooh, I hate that I care. Ooh, hear the way I do for
you. Brand new music on 947. Lloyiso jamming on his own song. This one is called I Hate That I Care.
I love it so much.
And it drops today.
It dropped today. It's already out. Go get it. I Hate That I Care. It's one of my favorite songs that I've ever written. And I'm so excited for everybody to hear it.
It's a thing of beauty. One thing I know about 947 is that we love you and we play you all the time.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to add this one to this oeuvre of music that we've got coming from you.
Bro, amazing.
We're out of time. Thank you so much for joining.
Thank you, Mo. It's been amazing chatting to you, man.
And all the best with the album and the brand new song as well.
Awesome. Thanks, brother.
Done deal. Singer-songwriter Lloyiso. Check him out on social media and check out the brand new tune. Mo Flava on 947.